so good either, and that you know could be looking a whole lot better. Maybe you're living with your soulmate and are joyfully sharing your gifts with the world, but are so broke that your dog is on his own if he wants to get fed. Maybe you're doing great financially and you have a deep connection to your higher purpose, but you can't remember the last time you wet your pants laughing. Or maybe you suck equally at all of the above and spend your free time crying, or drinking, or getting pissed off at all the meter maids who have precision timing and no sense of humor who, in your mind, are partly responsible for your personal financial crisis. Or maybe you have everything you've ever wanted, but for some reason, you still feel unfulfilled. This isn't necessarily about making millions of dollars or helping solve the world's problems or getting your own TV show, unless that's your thing. Your calling could simply be to take care of your family or to grow the perfect tulip. This is about getting mighty clear about what makes you happy and what makes you feel the most alive, and then creating it instead of pretending you can't have it, or that you don't deserve it, or that you're a greedy, egomaniacal fathead for wanting more than you already have, or listening to what Dad and Aunt Mary think you should be doing. It's about having the cojones to show up as the brightest, happiest, badassiest version of yourself, whatever that looks like to you. The good news is that in order to do this, all you need to do is make one simple shift. You need to go from wanting to change your life to deciding to change your life. Wanting can be done sitting on the couch with a bong in your hand and a travel magazine in your lap. Deciding means jumping in all the way, doing whatever it takes, and going after your dreams with the tenacity of a dateless cheerleader a week before prom night. You'll probably have to do things you never imagined you'd do because if any of your friends saw you doing it or spending money on it, you'd never live it down. Or they'd be concerned about you. Or they'd stop being friends with you because now you're all weird and different. You'll have to believe in things you can't see as well as some things that you have full-on proof are impossible. You're going to have to push past your fears, fail over and over again, and make a habit of doing things you're not so comfy doing. You're going to have to let go of old, limiting beliefs and cling to your decision to create the life you desire like your life depends on it. Because guess what? Your life does depend on it. As challenging as this may sound, it's nowhere near as brutal as waking up in the middle of the night feeling like someone parked a car on your chest, crushed under the realization that your life is zooming by and you have yet to start living it in a way that has any real meaning to you. You may have heard stories about people who had these major breakthroughs when the shit really hit the fan. They found a lump, or got their electricity turned off, or were moments away from having sex with strangers to buy drugs when suddenly they woke up, transformed. But you don't have to wait until you hit rock bottom to start crawling out of your hole. All you have to do is make the decision, and you can make it right now. There's a great line from the poet Anais Nin that reads, "And the day came when the risk to remain tight in a bud was more painful than the risk it took to blossom." This is how it was for me, and how I think it is for most people. My journey was a process, and still is, that started with my decision to make some serious changes, regardless of what I had to do to make them. None of the things I'd already tried were working. Mulling it over and over with my equally broke friends and my therapist, working my ass off, going out for a beer and hoping it would take care of itself. I was at the point where I would try anything to get my act together. And lordy, lord, 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 it's like the universe was testing me to see just how serious I was. I went to motivational seminars where they made me wear a name tag and high-five the person next to me while shouting, "You're awesome and so am I!" I beat a pillow with a baseball bat and shrieked like I was on fire. I bonded with my spirit guide, participated in a group ceremony where I married myself, wrote a love letter to my uterus, read every self-help book under the sun, and spent blood-curdling amounts of money I did not have hiring private coaches. Basically, I took one for the team. If you're new to the self-help world, I'm hoping this book will ease you into some of the basic concepts that totally changed my life so you can have a breakthrough too, without making you want to run off screaming in the process. If you've already dipped your toe in the self-help pond, I hope it will say something in a new way that turns a light on so you can make some major...